পিস টিভি বাংলা, মানবতা সমাধান।
Even if it is one verse.
So you are the messenger of the messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
The Quran from cover to cover is a message of peace.
And the last and final instruction manual for the human beings, it is the glorious Quran.
My beloved brothers and sisters, did you know that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forbade the believers from undertaking a special journey for sole purpose of visiting any place of worship except the three holy masjids, Masjid al-Haram in Makkah, Masjid al-Nabawi in Medina, and Masjid al-Aqsa in Jerusalem? We have had this hadith in Sahihain, alhamdulillah. We would now want to kindle a desire in you to visit these three masjids. Let us hear the adhans of these three masjids, al-Haram, al-Nabawi, and al-Aqsa, the brothers Abdul Hafiz Mullah, Zayd Waris, and Nuh Fahim respectively.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله لا إله إلا الله
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على
বিশ্বাসের অভাব, অসচেতন জীবন যাপন, ধর্মকে ভুলভাবে তুলে ধরা, ধর্মীয় গ্রন্থের পরিবর্তন এবং সংস্করণ যথাযথ তথ্য পেতে সকল ক্ষেত্রে আমি সংগ্রাম করছি সত্য প্রকাশ করতে, কারণ এটা যারা আপনার অধিকার আর আমার দায়িত্ব সত্যটা বলা।
দেখুন সত্য উন্মোচন আজ রাত 9টায় আর পুনঃ সম্প্রচার সকাল 7:30টায় বাংলাদেশে পিস টিভি বাংলায়। নবীজি মুহাম্মদ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লামের মনি বক্তা আবু হুরায়রা রাদিয়াল্লাহু আনহু থেকে বর্ণিত, রাসূলুল্লাহ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লাম বলেন, কারো সম্পর্কে ধারণা করা থেকে দূরে থাকো, কারণ ধারণা অধিকতর মিথ্যা হয়ে থাকে। কারো কোনো দোষ অনুসন্ধান করো না, গোয়েন্দাগিরি করো না, প্রলুব্ধ করো না, পরস্পর হিংসা করো না, পরস্পর শত্রুতা করো না, অন্যের পিছনে লেগো না, বরং আল্লাহর বান্দা হিসেবে পরস্পর ভাই ভাই হয়ে যাও। সহি বুখারি 8ম খণ্ড, শিষ্টাচার অধ্যায়, অনুচ্ছেদ 57, হাদিস নম্বর 6066।
The prodigy Dai of Islam, Farif Naik.
I challenge any human being to point out a single fundamental of Islam.
The illustrious son of the world famous orator of Islam, Dr. Zakir Naik.
Ek Abraham dutya naste. Bhagwan ek hi hai, dursa nahi hai. Nahi hai, zara bhi nahi hai.
Motivating towards the true path.
No Muslim is a Muslim if he does not believe in Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. Science without religion is lame, and religion without science is blind.
With his thrilling words and inspirational temperament,
demanding dowry from the would-be bride is completely prohibited in Islam. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, the one endowed with knowledge and wisdom. I am proud to be a fundamentalist Muslim.
Dekhu, Kishore Taroka. পরবর্তী অনুষ্ঠান পিস টিভি বাংলায়।
ফাহাদ আব্দুর রহমান অফ গ্রেড 8 টু এক্সপ্লেইন এন্ড ক্লারিফাই হোয়াট শরিয়া রিয়েলি ইজ। উইথ হিজ অ্যাম্বিশন টু বিকাম আ রিসার্চ সায়েন্টিস্ট, ফাহাদ'স ইন্সপিরেশন টু বি দ্য বেস্ট ইজ নন আদার দ্যান আওয়ার নোবেল প্রফেট Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Fahd possesses good communication skills and can elucidate any matter in a simple yet clear style. A very quiet boy who talks only when necessary has won the certificate for discipline in the year 2013. Fahd loves outdoor activities and takes great interest in playing football and cycling. Fahd wants to do da'wah wherever he goes and encourages his peers in the same direction. Sharia, barbaric or perfect? The creator of the heavens and the earth did not leave the creation in a state of anarchy. Instead, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has laid down for us a meticulous set of laws. The Sharia. It is surprising that the world today has welcomed and accepted evil with open arms. forsaking, morally uplifting, and society cultivating, perfect laws of the Sharia. To deal with this topic in detail, I call upon Brother Fahad Abdul Rahman with his words of wisdom to speak on the topic, Sharia, barbaric or perfect.
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا ادخلوا في السلم كافة ولا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان إنه لكم عدو مبين رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري وَحْلُ الْأُقْدَةَ مِنْ لِسَانِي يَفْقَوْ قَوْلِي My respected elders and my dear brothers and sisters, I welcome all of you with the Islamic greetings. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May peace, mercy and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be on all of you. The topic of my talk is Sharia, barbaric or perfect. Sharia is a complete code of Islamic law which pertains to the rights and duties of the Muslim. It regulates the lives of the people. It is comprehensive and includes from the minutest detail about eating, drinking, clothing, up to the complex system of lawmaking. The word Sharia literally means the clear path to follow. The Islamic Sharia is derived from four sources. First is the glorious Quran. The Quran is the last and final revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the last and final prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Quran is the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the word of God. It is also called as the Furqan, which means the criteria to judge right from wrong. The Quran was revealed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam through Archangel Gabriel 1400 years ago for approximately 23 years. The Quran contains 114 surahs or chapters and more than 6,000 ayats, signs, verses from which at least 1,000 speak about ahkam, the rulings, the do's and the don'ts. This Quran, the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the highest and the first source of Sharia. The second source is the Sunnah, which means the way of the Prophet, or the sayings, actions, and silent approvals of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As mentioned in the Sahih Hadith, that is the authentic sayings of the Prophet, the Sunnah, or the authentic Hadith, are supplementary to the Quran. They act as a commentary to the Quran. It gives an explanation to the verses of the Quran. In the Sunnah, the commandments of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam take precedence of his actions. And many a time, if you have to find more details about the commandments, you have to look into the life of the Sahaba. Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 59, Allah says, Ya ayyuha allatheena amanu atiu Allah wa atiu Rasul. O you who believe, obey Allah and obey the Messenger. Obeying the Messenger means obeying the Sunnah, the authentic sayings of the Prophet. If you want to find more details about the life of the Prophet, the best people who understood the sayings of the Prophet were the companions, were the Sahaba radiallahu anhuma, those who saw the Prophet, those who lived with the Prophet, and those who died in the state of Iman. If you want to understand the Hadith much better, you have to look into the lifestyle of the Sahaba, then the next generation, then the next generation. So the Sunnah, the authentic Hadith, is the second source of Sharia. The third source is the ijma, which means the consensus of opinion or the agreement of the opinions of the Sahaba radhiyallahu anhum, followed by the consensus of the opinion of the Muslim jurists of the first three centuries of Hijra. If you don't find any direct answer in the Quran, then look into the Sunnah. If you don't find it there, then look into the ijma, consensus of opinion. This is the third source. And the fourth source is qiyas. Qiyas means to judge and come closer to make a judgment based on the reasoning that if you don't find any direct indication in the Quran or in the Sunnah or in the Ijma, then a qualified scholar, a mujtahid, can use his own logic to try and find the answer based on the other verses of the Quran and the Sunnah and the Ijma using analogy. But this can only be done after the Ijma. So basically, there are four sources for the Sharia. First and the highest in authority is the glorious Quran. Second is the Sunnah, the authentic sayings of the Prophet. Third source is the Ijma, and the fourth source is Qiyas. As I said earlier, the Islamic Sharia is a complete code of conduct. It gives a person a complete way of life and how it should be led. But unfortunately, you find in the media and many critics of Islam, they present the Sharia as barbaric. And most of the allegations regarding Sharia, most of them, major of them revolve around two aspects. First is the form of punishment in Islam. They may show a poster or a front cover of a book of a man being whipped, maybe his naked back being whipped or his hands being chopped. And the second is the women in Islam, that they are subjugated. They may show a woman in hijab. These two are the main factors with the critics of Islam. They attack Sharia. They say it is barbaric. And there are a few more. Time will not permit us to discuss all the aspects of Sharia. Neither will time permit us to reply to all the allegations that the media and the critics of Islam have regarding Sharia. In the time available, inshallah, I will try and clarify few of the misconceptions regarding Sharia. First, as I mentioned, many Western writers and critics of Islam, they attack Islam because of the forms of punishment prescribed in Islamic law. They say that the punishments are barbaric. Islam is a complete way of life. And if you compare to other ways of life, most other religions, if you analyze, they speak good things. Most of the religions, including Islam. Then what's the difference between Islam and the other religions? Islam, besides just speaking good things, it shows you a way how to achieve that state of goodness. For example, every religion says you should not rob. Hinduism says you should not rob. Christianity says you should not rob. Islam says the same. Then what's the difference between Islam and the other religions? Islam, besides just telling you not to rob, it shows you a way how to achieve a state in which the people will not rob. Islam has a system of zakat, in which every rich human being who has a saving of more than the nisab level, who has a saving of more than 85 grams of gold, should give 2.5% of his excess wealth every lunar year. If every rich human being gives zakat, poverty will be eradicated from this world. There will not be a single human being who will die of hunger. After this, the glorious Quran says in Surah Ma'idah, chapter number 5, verse number 38, وَالسَّارِقُ وَالسَّارِقَةُ فَاقْطَعُوا أَيْدِيهُمَا جَزَاءً بِمَا كَسَبَ نَكَالًا مِنَ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ. Allah says, as to the thief, be it man or woman, chop off his or her hands as a punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And verily, Allah is almighty, all wise. Non-Muslims say, chopping off the hands, this age of science and technology in this 21st century, Islam is a barbaric religion. It's a ruthless way of life. Islam is such, it gives you advice that don't rob. But everybody will not follow this advice. People who have faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will follow. Everybody will not. So for them, the punishment is also laid down. I'm asking you the question, that today, America happens to be one of the most advanced countries in the world. But do you know, it is the country with the maximum number of theft and robbery? I'm asking you the question, if you implement the Islamic Sharia in the USA, that if any rich human being who has a saving of more than 85 grams of gold gives 2.5% of his excess wealth every lunar year, and that if any human being, man or woman, robs, his or her hands will be chopped off, what do you think will happen to the rate of theft and robbery in the USA? Will it increase, remain the same, or decrease? Will it increase, remain the same, or decrease? It will decrease. It's a practical law. You implement the Sharia, you get the results. You implement the Sharia anywhere. It doesn't have to be a Muslim country. You implement the Sharia in the USA, there too you will get the results. People fail to realize that the Islamic Sharia is complete. It's perfect. That doesn't mean if a poor man robs because he's hungry, his hands will be chopped off. If a poor man robs because he's hungry, it is the duty of the state. It is the duty of the Islamic State that they provide food for him. Why did he have to rob for food? It is the duty of the Ummah that we see to it that the neighbors don't go hungry. But naturally, this punishment has its rules and regulations. that only if you steal a particular big amount from a sacred place, then it's implemented. And the question of a person robbing food should not even arise in an Islamic state. That's the reason the country with the least rate of theft and robbery in this world is Saudi Arabia. If you implement the Sharia, you get the results. This was just an example of a punishment and the logic behind this punishment. That's the reason I say that Islam, besides just speaking good things, it shows you a way how to achieve that state of goodness. So the other religions, they are theoretical. Islam is a practical religion. So practically, if you want to care for humanity, practically, if you really want the evil to be destroyed from this world, you have to accept Islam.
যাদের পথে চলা যায় না, তারা কারা? প্রতি রাকাত সালাতে তো তাদের কথাই পড়ছি। গায়রিল মাগদুব আলাইহিম ওয়ালাদদাল্লিন, সিরাতাল লাযীনা আনআমত আলাইহিম গায়রিল মাগদুব আলাইহিম তবে কি ইচ্ছে করে অথবা জ্ঞানের ভুলে আমরা অনেকেই ছুটে চলেছি সেই অভিশপ্ত এবং ভ্রান্তদের পথে। জানতে দেখুন বিস্তৃতি বাংলায় আমাদের আয়োজন যাদের পথে চলা যায় না।
জানেন কেন ইসলাম মন্দ পথকে নির্বাচন না করার নির্দেশ দিয়েছে? যাদের পথে চলা যায় না প্রতি রবিবার রাত ১০টায় আর পুনঃ সম্প্রচার সকাল ৮:৩০টায় বাংলাদেশে পিস টিভি বাংলায়।
পিস টিভি প্রেজেন্টস
Learning the wise way.
What would you recommend us to take as career?
After we pass our school, so what exactly we should do?
What do you have to say about pursuing two fields together?
Ideas brilliant. Strategy sustained.
The best profession is a profession of a person who invites people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Avail the opportunity with Dr. Zakir.
Depending upon what is your interest, what a meaning, should be to spread the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
To implement the convincing Islamic cum educational formula to excel in your career, dekhun career guidance proti robibar raat 6:30 tay apuno samprochar sokal 9:30 tay bangladeshe peace tv banglay.